There is no question about it. Rheumatoid arthritis is an increasingly prevalent and important disease to know about and to discuss about. You may have friends or family members with rheumatoid arthritis. In that case, one of the first things that may come into your mind is, how can I prevent rheumatoid arthritis from happening to me?
Rheumatologistoncall.com.
This is a conversation I frequently have in my rheumatology office, especially with relatives of newly diagnosed patients. What are the risk factors to develop rheumatoid arthritis? Let's talk about some rheumatoid arthritis risk factors. Number one is familial or genetic factors. In my previous lecture, I have discussed how certain genes or having a first or second degree relative with rheumatoid arthritis will affect your risk to develop this disease. If you want to learn more, check the video in my channel. So, having a relative in your family with rheumatoid arthritis will definitely increase your risk to develop this disease at some point in life. But again, this is not a disease that is genetically transmitted to you from your parents. Now let's talk about demographic factors like your age, biological sex, socioeconomic status, and the geographical area where you live, because those can increase the risk of developing rheumatoid arthritis. Let me give you a few examples. Middle-aged females, or females between the age of 60 and 65, are at higher risk to develop rheumatoid arthritis. Also, people in Western countries are more likely to develop rheumatoid arthritis. People with lower socioeconomic status are also at increased risk. Now, you may have noticed that all those risk factors are things out of your control. But what are the things that you can control? Can your habits cause rheumatoid arthritis? Smoking, poor diet, obesity, and lack of physical exercise are all common habits that are associated with an increased risk to develop rheumatoid arthritis. Smoking is the leading habit on the list. There are many studies that confirm the increased risk of rheumatoid arthritis in smokers. Even if you quit smoking, the risk will be there. It is very important to know that children of smokers who were exposed to cigarette smoke have an increased risk to develop rheumatoid arthritis later in life. I will link all these studies in the description of this video. If you are exposed to other sources of smoke, such as living in an area with high pollution, bad air quality, or working in a toxic environment, will also increase your risk. Our physical health also has an impact on this risk. People that are obese with a BMI of over 30 will have a 30% increase to develop rheumatoid arthritis. Lastly, poor dental hygiene, which can lead to the presence of certain bacterial species like Prevotella, are also associated with an increased risk for rheumatoid arthritis. As you can see, our lifestyle choices can have a great impact on the rheumatoid arthritis risk. Now you're gonna wonder, what if I change my lifestyle? Will that prevent rheumatoid arthritis? There is a mountain of evidence regarding changes in your lifestyle that might prevent rheumatoid arthritis or change the outcome of those that are already diagnosed with rheumatoid arthritis. I'll give you a few examples, but there are many, many studies to prove the role of nutrition in treating autoimmune diseases, including rheumatoid arthritis. Those interventions include vitamin D supplementation, fish oil, omega-3 fatty acids, consuming spices like turmeric, or adhering to a Mediterranean diet. They have been proven to help your rheumatoid arthritis or decrease the risk of rheumatoid arthritis. I have many videos in my channel where I talk extensively about the scientific evidence of these interventions, so I invite you to check them. I have also designed a pyramid for lifestyle changes for rheumatoid arthritis patients that you can find here in this channel or on my blog. I do advise my patients to eat certain foods that will have anti-inflammatory effects. Make sure you get enough sleep, reduce your amount of stress, continue exercising, and try to be mindful about your activities. All of this have been proven to help your rheumatoid arthritis symptoms. Now you may be wondering, why do I spend so much time talking about the relationship between lifestyle interventions and arthritis? That's because I'm a strong advocate for integrative medicine, which is an approach to healthcare combining the traditional medical system and lifestyle changing, including nutrition and mindfulness. Only targeting a disease does not get to the root of the problem. As I have said again and again, it is like treating one tree from a sick forest and expecting all to heal. If you are interested, I have an online course that will give you a strategic approach to all the lifestyle interventions from nutrition, exercise, and stress management to help you decrease the pain, improve your symptoms, and decrease the need to use more medications. I will post the link in the description of the video. Not only that it will help you understand your disease, but will also teach you how to live a life, a full life, even thrive with rheumatoid arthritis. I would like to remind you that this video is just for educational purposes and does not offer you medical advice or substitute a diagnosis. If you are concerned about rheumatoid arthritis or other autoimmune diseases, you should consult a rheumatologist who will be able to evaluate you and make a proper diagnosis and give you the right treatment. In conclusion, rheumatoid arthritis has many causes. You cannot change your genetics, but you can change your likelihood for developing rheumatoid arthritis and how it affects you by making lifestyle changes, like quitting smoking, remaining active, reducing your stress, sleeping more and better, maintaining a good oral hygiene, and eating a healthy diet. Thank you very much for watching my channel. I hope you learned something new and valuable about rheumatoid arthritis and how can you change the course of your disease. Have a wonderful day.
Rheumatologistoncall.com